a column of 400 by 400 mm carries a dead load of 800 and imposed load of 300. The self-bearing pressure is 200 kilonewton per meter square. Design a square base to resist the load. The concrete is grade 35 and reinforcement grade is 460. The condition of exposure is moderate to non-aggressive soil and nominal cover is 40 mm. For concrete cast against blinding. Assume a footing weight of 130 kN and overall depth of footing is 600. Use 20 mm diameter bar. 400 by 400, this one adalah C. Tapi C bukan concrete cover. It is column width. 800 kN is dead load. 300 is imposed load, safe bearing pressure, PB, concrete grade, this one FCU lah, reinforcement 460 FY, this one also adalah C, 40 mm tu, cast against concrete blinding, but it is for concrete cover. Footing weight lah, so this one adalah self weight of footing, dia dah bagi, so kita tak perlu assume, kalau tak kita kena assume eh. Overall depth of footing, this one is H. And 20 mm, this one adalah diameter of main reinforcement. Okay. A lot of information here. Usually, bila kita design for footing, we need to design the base size dulu. Serviceability load, bila kita design for RC, kita kena consider the SLS and ULS, the serviceability state and ultimate limit state. We also call it as N. 1.0 GK plus 1.0 QK plus 1.0 W. Masukkan je. W here is the self weight of footing. Okay, assuming a footing weight tu equal to 130. This one eh. Kat sini dia dah bagi assumption. Then you just use the assumption. My answer is 1230 kilonewton. Kalau you nak lagi selamat lah, you boleh letak lah W130 so that you tahu 130 drop kat mana-mana. Tengok dekat atas. Find the size of base using the serviceability load over the bearing capacity PB tu eh. N is 1230 kilonewton. The PB 200 kilonewton per meter square. 6.15 meter square. Ini area base. Yeah, we need to find the size. As in satu side berapa meter, satu side lagi berapa meter. Therefore, kita just square root kan saja 6.15 meter square to get each side punya 2.4799, so jadi 2.48 lah. This is the minimum size eh, maksudnya satu LY dengan LX eh, sebab I pernah explain kan which one is LY, which one is LX. So you ada base like this, this is a plan view, so you ada ini column dekat tengah lah. Ini LX, ini LY. The minimum value for both LY dengan LX adalah 2.48, round it up to 2.5. meter. Provide 2.5 meter times 2.5 meter, which is the actual area is 6.25. Sebab you dah round up dia, bila you kira balik area, you ambil je 2.5, darab 2.5, you will get 6.25. Kita nak check betul tak self weight tu 130 kN. I know that dia bagi, tapi dia bagi tak semestinya betul. Self weight. While here, you ambil the value of volume darab dengan unit weight of concrete. So 6.25 tu adalah area. And you pun kena darab dengan height. The overall depth of footing is 600 millimeter. You darab dengan unit weight of concrete. My answer is 90. 0.6 ni nanti you confuse mana dapat. So you bolehlah kat atas ni, H equal to 600 millimeter. Daripada our answer here, 90 kilonewton ni kita nak compare lah dengan the self weight of footing yang kita guna masa kita kira serviceability load. This one. Ini memang soalan bagi. Tapi macam mana pun kita tetap kena check. So 90 kilonewton ni kalau kita pakai size macam ni footing, self weight dia less than the one yang kita assume, which is the 130. Walaupun kita tak assume, walaupun soalan tu yang bagi, kena juga compare. Okey lah, dia tak boleh lebih. Ini adalah minimum kalau kita pakai size 2.5 × 2.5 × 0.6. Inilah weight sebenar. Next, kita akan start kira for bending reinforcement sebab kita dah dapat the size of the base. Ultimate load 1.4 GK plus 1.6 QK. It is 1600 kilonewton.
Saya ada satu soalan, guys.
Apa dia?
Why need to be like for the surface footing, kenapa perlu darat dengan 0.6? I mean like if tak ada, miss, perlu cari dia punya height tu juga ke, miss?
Not really. If not given, you have to assume.
Because
compare with the serviceability load, masa you kira awal ni kan, you ada kira dengan this 130 kN ni. You can compare with the same value 130 kN. Masa you kira serviceability load, sometimes value 130 tu pun dia tak bagi. Okay, kadang-kadang lah dia tak bagi. H pun dia mungkin tak bagi. Benda macam ni kadang-kadang you kena assume. But sebab masa you kira serviceability load, you dah kena assume that 130 is not given. If given, then you can just put lah. But that value tak semestinya betul. You just use that value for the sake of calculation saja. But later on, dekat bawah ni you have to check again. Okay, that's why H ni pun you kena assume. Kalau tak, but tak diberi ya. Next, we need to calculate the ultimate earth pressure, which is PS. By using the ultimate design load, divide with the area of base. 1600 kilonewton divide with 6.25 meter square. I dapat 256 kilonewton per meter square. Ultimate earth pressure ni, you kira sebab you nak tengok untuk 1 meter square of the footing, berapa load yang being transferred to the ground. Sebab you ada total 1600 kilonewton, berapa banyak yang being transferred to the ground. Kita kira the MYY, which is moment dekat YY, PS darab LY darab LX minus C divide with 2 darab LX minus C divide with 4. PS is 256. LY is terpakai 2.5 meter kan, darab 2.5. So LY adalah 2.5 meter darab 2.5 meter minus C here is column width, a 400 × 400 mm column. Dia jadi 0.4 lah kalau dalam meter. 352.8 kilonewton meter. Kita dah dapat moment dekat YY. Ini 2.5 kan? Ini 2.5. Column 0.4. Then YY tu kat sini lah. Kita nak the one yang I color. Ini kira-kira separuh. Ini tu sama je kan? Dia ada side pun akan sama. Dia ada one yang dekat atas ni pun akan sama. Dekat sini pun sama. Dekat sini pun sama. Dekat sini sama. Kita kira untuk separuh lah. Ini area yang prone to bending. That's why kita ambil that particular area untuk kira the moment. Kita nak dapatkan area tu kan. That's why LY. So 2.5 meter. This one eh. Kita darab LY ni. But kita nakkan area yang I shaded tu. So 2.5 meter. Darab berapa panjang ni ha? So itulah 2.5 meter minus 0.4 bahagi 2, which is 3.125 meter kat sini. Bila you kira, okay, 2.5 meter dan 2.5 meter times 3.125 meter. Area yang shaded tu eh, daripada the centroid nak pergi ke face of the column, because you ambil moment sampai face of the column. So obviously it is, you dah tahu darab dengan 3.125 meter bahagi sebab tengah-tengah eh. Kalau dia punya lebar tu 3.125, half of it lah bagi 2. Value yang dapat untuk yang area dan dia punya distance from centroid tu, yang kat ini semua ni adalah ni eh. Ha, and then kena darab dengan the ultimate earth pressure. Ada orang dia tak pakai this formula sebab sebenarnya dia tak ada formula ni. Formula ni saya memandai je. Sebenarnya you kena lukis and then you kira sendiri. Next step is kita kena check dulu for sure eh. Sebab I bagi tahu dalam syllabus kita tak belajar kan pasal transverse shear and punching shear, how to calculate.
Mau tanya yang 3.125
meter
ni nak.
Huh?
Kenanya besar
kita per 2.5 meter. Kenapa? I salah kira eh. Ini dia 1.05. Ya, I betulkan balik tadi. 2.5 meter darab 1.05 meter. Darab 1.05 meter bahagi 2. Preliminary check. D is, kita macam ni kita kira the total height is D plus full bar plus C. Bukan half bar. For footing, dia almost similar to slab. Dia ada reinforcement down here. Banyak lah. Both of these reinforcement adalah main reinforcement. Dia tak ada secondary reinforcement. Dari side view eh, you ada main reinforcement satu level dekat bawah ni. You ada lagi satu level of main reinforcement yang cross each other eh. Dia punya effective depth akan jadi daripada top of the footing sampai the first main reinforcement tu. Sebab main reinforcement dia sama jenis, sama size. So obviously kita akan ambil tengah-tengah lah antara kedua reinforcement tu. So ini adalah dia punya effective depth. And you ada lagi one layer of reinforcement and baru you jumpa concrete cover. Preliminary check for shear, kita kira D, H minus full bar and minus C. H is 600 mm, minus full bar dia dah bagi dalam soalan pakai 20 mm. If not given, you are free to use according to your design. Untuk footing, kita takkan pakai size besar sangat juga. I know that footing memang carry load yang banyak. Tapi bila you design, tak adalah pakai size besar-besar. Kalau tak, nanti spacing dia akan jadi besar juga. Bila bar size dia besar, number of bar dia akan kurang kan? Bila number of bar dia akan kurang, spacing dia akan makin besar lah. Biasanya kita akan pakai like 16 mm, something like that eh. Dia takkan go up until 32 mm like that. We need to minus with 40 mm the concrete cover because they cast against blinding. Kalau without blinding, 75 mm. 5.40. Kita nak check preliminary saja because kita tak check the actual punching shear dengan transverse shear. We just ambil 8 and square root kan the value of N, which is the serviceability load. Serviceability load here is 1,230.280.571. Comparekan dengan value of D. So D is 540, you kira the prelim check ni, you dapat the less than 540, which is the one yang you pakai, which means dia okay. Ni cara biasa lah. M here, you akan pakai value of MYY, convert into Newton millimeter. FCU given grade 30 for concrete. B ikut the LX dengan LY, itulah. Kita dah ada the dimension 2.5 meter times 2.5 meter, which means B is 2,500 millimeter. Kita punya D, okay, kita dah kira masa kita check for preliminary, it is 540 mm.
0.016.
And
that... Oh, yes, bukan FCU-nya adalah 35, guys.
Good. Thank you. Banyak orang betulkan saya hari ni. FCU is 35. 0.985D. Which is bigger than 0.95D. Bila kita kira for AF, kita pakailah the value 0.95D replace kat dalam value Z for this one eh. M is MYY eh. 352.8. FY is 460 grit steel.
MK bukan 0.014 kah?
Ya, 84. Okay, luckily dia tak ada effect kat bawah ni. 1573.728. Kita nak pilih daripada this table. So this is the normal table yang kita pakai masa kita kira beam, column, slab line. So refer to this one. So kita kena select yang 20mm punya diameter sebab dia suruh kita pakai tanyakan. So 1573. The nearest will be 6T20. 1890 ni lah. Sebab kalau kita ambil 5T20 tak cukup. Before kita boleh kata okay, kita kena tengok dulu distribution of reinforcement. 3C over 4 plus 9D over 4. That 3 darab C. C here bukan concrete cover. It is column width. So kalau column width, we know that dimension of the column is 400 by 400. C dia 400 lah. And value of D is 540. My answer is 1515mm. Then kita check dengan LC ya. LC ni adalah daripada centroid of column. Pergi ke face of the footing. Separuh LX tu adalah LC. Ni LX ni LY kan. Ha, so daripada tengah ni, center of the footing. Pergi ke berapa panjang ni? Separuh lah. So LC is LX divide with 2. LX is 2500mm. Divide with 2, you will get 1250mm. Sambung during our tutorial class later. Thank you so much. Sama. Have a nice day. Bye.